The thing that you should be most afraid of in life is not the monster that's chasing you up the stairs from the basement, because once you get into the main floor, you're fine. You're in the golden. What you're supposed to actually fear, guys, is regret. Not the fear of failing or succeeding, but the fear of not doing something that you wish you would have done. So guys, today I'm going over the 7 things I wish I knew as a teenager, things that I didn't do and I wish I had known. So let's get right into this video, guys. Don't buy designer clothes. I hope you guys know that buying Gucci and Louis V isn't gonna make you look any hotter. First of all, these prices are freaking ridiculous. I just found this sweater on Gucci and it has a chick hatching out of an egg that is worth over 2 grand. Like, what are you thinking when you're buying this? Are you in your head and you're like,
damn, I'm gonna pick up so many bad bitches rocking this.
Maybe, guys, maybe it's just me. Maybe I just don't know how fresh it is to roll up wearing a chick on my sweater. Guys, I've said this before in another video, and it is not about the brand. It's about how you style the clothes and how they fit you. As a teen, you really don't have the money to be spending 2 grand on a sweater, guys. Like, really, as a teenager, you have more priorities than to be spending it on a Gucci sweater with a chick hatching out of an egg, you know what I mean? You don't need to have it all figured out. I feel like there's this rush and this pressure to, you know, figure it out. I've had people come up to me and be like,
"Well, buddy, you're like 20 years old. You better figure it out pretty soon. You're getting pretty old."
What does figure it out mean? Are you supposed to be able to plan out your life at 18, 19 years old? Guys, I just find that this is such nonsense because the people who are telling you to so-called figure it out don't even have their own lives figured out. The problem with this is that your life is going to constantly change over time. Where you are now and where you want to be when you're older might be completely different as you get there. So many people are in a rush to like figure it out and they don't actually spend time in the present. They're not really present ever. They're always thinking about, oh, what's the next step? What's the next step? This is what causes anxiety and other problems because you're literally trying to predict the future, which I hope you know is not possible yet. I mean, Elon Musk hasn't created no freaking nano chip that can go in your brain so you can predict the future. So that might be coming, but at least of right now, that is not possible. Don't be afraid to not know what your life holds for you, because you can shoot for one place and you're probably gonna end up in the complete other direction. You're not the same person as you are when you're 19 as you are when you're 40. Time is your asset, guys. If you're 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, all the way up until you're 35, go have as many experiences as you can. Try something new. Okay, you don't like it, go try something else. This is the time to try things. If you wanna go travel, go travel. If you wanna start a business, start a business. If you wanna go do a freaking little dance class, to feel it's right, all the attraction. Go do it, guys. The worst thing that's gonna happen is that you don't like it, and that's it. That's it. Go do something else then. Do not buy expensive cars. Oh boy, where do I start with this? The problem for me and a lot of other people is that we enjoy our cars. Like, it is a hobby to own them, to drive them. It's more of a passion, guys. The problem with buying these, guys, is yes, you might be able to afford the initial cost of the car, like a BMW or a Mercedes. And that's really only because they've already taken such a depreciation hit because cars just depreciate like crazy. So that car that came out like 3 years ago was $50,000 or more expensive, and now it's like 15 grand. Yes, you might be able to afford to buy the car, but have you taken into account that you would have to pay for the repairs, and they're still just as expensive because repairs do not depreciate like cars do. I know me telling you is probably not going to change your mind because my parents tried to do the exact same thing. They told me, Brandon, don't get a BMW, don't get a Mercedes. It's just gonna break and it's gonna cost you a lot of money. You may be able to afford it. Exact same talk that I'm having with you right now. What happens? 30 minutes into me driving the car on the highway, and I'm not even joking, guys, this actually happened. My car broke. 30 minutes. Boom. Towed. I was devastated. Worst day of my life. Like 30 minutes, are you kidding me? Not even a day, not even 2 days, couldn't even be 3 hours. Nope, 30 minutes. Whatever, you have to learn from your mistakes, right? So guys, you really have to think about not only what is your initial cost, but what your repairs are going to be annually as well, because you can find all the averages and stuff of your vehicle. So just do that and then you'll see like, oh, a BMW is gonna cost me over $2,000 annual cost, or a Toyota might only be like $500 a year, or some Japanese vehicle because it's gonna last you a lot longer and you're gonna have a lot less problems. Appreciate your teen years, guys. You can almost do anything and it's not gonna affect your future. So obviously, just don't come like on the block and just start popping everybody, because yeah, that will land you 30 years in jail. Obviously, you'll never be able to leave the country again, and you get your freedom completely stripped away from you. So don't do anything like that. But you guys know what I mean. Man, I took the freedom I had for granted in high school big time. All I wanted to do was grow up and stop going to school. I'm like, this is such a waste of time. I can't wait to start working. And what do you know? Now I'm working and I want to go back. Now looking back, I wish I just appreciated seeing my friends every day more, having no obligations, mooching off the parents, playing Black Ops 2, MW3, MW2 till like 3 a.m. You hop on, all the boys are on, we're like, let's go. Those were the times, guys. And now just thinking about it, it's already bringing back the memories. I really want to emphasize in this whole video just to really enjoy your time, be present, because you will never get to experience this type of freedom that you have right now ever again in your life. Read more books. I had always hated reading. I absolutely despised it. And it's so funny because I think, like, honestly, up until grade 12, I think I'd only ever read one book, and that was actually in grade 8, and it was The Outsiders. I'm not sure if you guys have all studied The Outsiders book, but that's like the first book that you read in high school. So I guess the whole 4 years after grade 8, I didn't read a single book. And then around grade 12, right after I graduated, actually, I got really into entrepreneurship. I had been saying that in grade 11 and grade 12, but I didn't really take any steps towards that. After graduation, I started taking some steps toward that, and I started reading books that actually made an impact in my life because it gave me an advantage over people that didn't know that information. So guys, when I say read more books, I'm not talking about reading a 2,000-page Harry Potter book. Expecto Patronum! Knowing it's cool and stuff, but like, what are you gonna do? You're gonna come up to somebody and be like,
yeah, bro, another Cruciatus curse? Well, how about this one? Do you know the Avada Kedavra curse?
You want to read books on finance, on investing, on self-development, conquering your mindset, all those different types of things. When I started reading these books, guys, seriously, it completely changed the way I think about everything. The way I look at jobs, the way I look at my friend group, the way I look at myself, the way that I think, what I tell myself, what I tell other people. Everything changed. Reading these books in the past 3 years has probably taught me 100 times more than I had learned in the whole 5 years of high school. My advice to you guys would be, whatever area you're trying to improve in your life, there is a book out there for that. And there's somebody that is way better than you at it. So whether that's, like I said, financing, investing, being strong-minded, being positive, there's always gonna be somebody else better than you. So drop the ego, go read their book, and I promise you this is going to transform your life. Stop caring what other people think of you. This is the most important thing I wish I'd learned early on in high school. I remember grade 8, grade 9, I was that guy that just wanted everyone to like me. And you know, like, I would even go to the extent of asking people why they didn't like me. And then when they would tell me they didn't like me for some reason, I would try to change myself to be more of that person that they wanted me to be. And then I just wouldn't be myself anymore. I just didn't feel like me. It's going to inhibit you from truly living your life because everything you will do will be controlled by other people and what other people think is right. At the end of the day, guys, you need to understand that you will not be able to please everyone that comes around in your life. It's impossible. People are gonna judge you no matter what you do. It doesn't matter if you're going for your dreams or doing nothing. So you might as well do something. And you know, if they say something, just say thank you for your feedback and then you're gonna move on. That's it. Once you get over that fear, you'll become unstoppable and then you can really start to live your life. It's called your life for a reason. Why would you ever let somebody else dictate what happens in your life? Because at that point, guys, you value others' opinions over your own opinions of yourself. So guys, just be yourself and not only will you feel more alive, but your friendships, your relationships, they're all gonna be more true because at least you'll know that these people love you for the way that you are. And that is it for today's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please smash that like button if you enjoyed this and subscribe and join our freaking awesome family that we got here. Solid 83 subscribers, but we're moving our way up, guys. So I really appreciate those who do subscribe. So I'll catch you in the next one. Your bro, Brandon. Peace out and take care, guys.